What's going on, people? It's your boy P-Bet. Back again with some Black Ops gameplay. Using the AK-47 because it was one of the recommended, or not recommended, it's one of the suggested weapons that people wanted me to use. So I said, why not? I like the AK-47. It's a really good gun. I've been using it since COD 4, and it's never let me down. Maybe except once, when I was in a really laggy lobby and I went like one in a million, but who cares? That's all in the past. You never heard that from me. So my favorite setup with the AK-47 is either the AK-47 with suppressor or the AK-47 with dual mags. Man, dual mags and sleight of hand in this game. God damn, that thing is deadly. It reloads in like half a second, not even half a second. Okay, picture the FAL reloading with sleight of hand in Modern Warfare 2, and then times that by 2. That's pretty much how fast the things in this game reload with dual mags and sleight of hand. It is ridiculous. You guys should definitely try that out if you haven't yet. And if you take a liking to it, then that's good. You should use it often, because it's deadly in the hands of a pro, or even in the hands of a champ. Yeah, but same thing. I mean, actually, I think champs are better than pros. Of course they are. So this Flintstones XD guy, I kill him. I'm not sure if that's, like, what is that? I don't know how many times I've killed him. But I think, yeah, he comes back. I kill him again. He just keeps coming. He doesn't learn. It's like he wants me to kill him. I knife this guy, and I turn around, and I wonder who's going to be behind me. I hope it's not that Flintstones XD guy. Oh, look. I killed Flintstones. Oh, wait, that's not him. But still, that was him that just came around the corner. And he gets picked off by the chopper, but whatever. As you can see, I'm still using the average kill streak that I always use, which is 8, 9, 11, Blackbird, Chopper Gunner, and a Gunship. I tear with those kill streaks. You have no idea. Like I said in the last episode, if you feel confident in yourself that you can get up to an 8 kill streak, that's pretty much it. You get the Blackbird, and then you see where the enemies are, and, you know, you're gonna get your extra 3 kills to get your final 2 kill streaks. It's just the way it is. I mean, I was thinking about how JD2020 said, I'm not sure if it was JD, I'm not sure if it was Josh Olin or it was David Van Vonderhaar. I think that's his name, but whatever. I'm not sure which one it was, but they said kill streaks in this game don't stack. Now, if you're thinking, you know, literally, or not literally, if you're thinking, like, technically, yeah, they don't stack, but if you have a Blackbird, they pretty much do stack, because once you get the Blackbird, what I tend to do, as you saw there, was I get the Blackbird, but I don't call it in right away. I get the Blackbird, and then I try and get my next 2 kill streaks. And then what I do after that is I use the gunship, chopper gunner, blah, blah, blah. And then I try, I don't think I do it this match, actually. I don't think I do it this match. But what I usually do is after I get my Blackbird, Chopper Gunner, Gunship, and then I use my Gunship and Chopper Gunner, I let the enemy team kill me. Because after that, I still have my Blackbird, and then I call in my Blackbird, and I see where the enemy team is. So once I see where they are, I rush them, I get my 11 kills all over again, get my Blackbird, Chopper Gunner, and Gunship, and then just cycle the whole process over and over, and you can get a bunch of kills in this game. I'm not sure if I told you guys this story yet, but I actually got a 286 kill game on Demolition on Nuketown, using the same setup and the same strategy I told you guys about. But this was like really early when Black Ops came out, and theater mode was having those problems where it would record different games and record random games that you weren't even in. And unfortunately, oh man, that was one of the games that I lost, and oh my god, was I ever mad. I thought, you know, that would be an amazing commentary, like amazing commentary material. But now, theater mode had to go and screw P-Bad over. So as you can see, firing range, I am absolutely annihilating these guys. But they weren't even trying to shoot down my air support right away. But spoiler alert. Halfway through the match, these guys end up leaving. I mean, yeah, you can't blame them. If I were them, I would probably have left too, if I was getting spawn raped like this. But they leave halfway through, and then more people join, and they love to shoot down air support, so that wasn't really good for me. If these same people stayed in the match the whole way through, if these people stayed in the match the whole way through, I probably would have gotten, I'm guessing approximately 150 kills, somewhere around there, I'm guessing, because they weren't the smartest enemy team, I'm telling you. But when these new guys joined, they were semi-skilled, and, you know, you know, knew where to shoot, knew where to, knew where to point their guns. They weren't just pointing their guns at the floor, they were actually pointing it at the enemies. And, you know, they were pretty skilled. But as you can see, I have the Blackbird. Like I said, I always rush with the Blackbird. I feel very confident when I have the Blackbird up. I feel like, you know, I feel like a real champion. I feel like I'm unstoppable. I feel like, you know, I feel like I'm not afraid to rush the enemy. Everybody, you're going to die. But, you know, the thing about the Blackbird in this game, I'm still kind of trying to think. Is it overpowered? I mean, for an 8 kill streak, it seems to give you a, you know, unfair advantage, dare I say, against the enemy team. And I'm just not sure if that's fair. I'm not sure how they could nerf it, though. I think it's too late to make it a higher kill streak. Well, it's not really too late, but I just don't see them doing that. Maybe you don't make it last as long. I think it lasts a minute right now. I think maybe make it last 45 seconds or 30 seconds, just so they can use it in dire situations. Or maybe even make it like a UAV where it refreshes every few seconds. I mean, it's not like they would have to be still on the radar, you know, every time the little wave goes by. But, I mean, like, make it so that every time the wave goes by, it shows their position and where they're moving, which way they're facing, but it kind of fades out every second. I think that would, you know, kind of nerf it, kind of make it a bit more fair. Because as it stands now, with the Blackbird up, you know, all it really is you gotta look where the enemy is, run into their spawn, god, that is not, you know, yeah, that is a word, run into their spawn and pre-fire the corners. I mean, and you're pretty much unstoppable. But as you see, I'm sprawn raping them here, and, man, they just, they're getting pretty mad, and as you can hear, they are trying to shoot down my stuff, which I kinda do respect. Kinda cheesed me off, because, you know, I was hoping to get an over 100 kill game here, but unfortunately, these people are smart, and I do respect that, because if I, like I said in the last video, if I was on the receiving end of these, kill streaks, I would want my team to shoot down air support. So I'm glad to see the communities actually coming together here, and, you know, I mean, in Modern Warfare 2, it seemed like people never shot down air support, at least when I was on the team. When I was on the receiving end of the killstreaks, you know, people are like, nah, just leave it. It's fine. We're just getting a few deaths in a video game. It's no big deal. When I was in the killstreaks, it was, oh, it's P-Bats, jump, I gotta shoot it down now! It's like, come on, guys, what's going on here? Am I just like a burden of bad luck, or like, what's going on here? I never understood it. I'm not sure if it was just because, I don't know, I always seem to have bad luck in these games, in these, oh, what do you kids call it these days? These first-person shooters, I've never had good luck in them. It seems like, I'm not sure if I have, actually, I know I'm not the only one with this problem, because I was watching the Machinima live stream earlier, and Ian, was playing. He's, the segment manager for Realm, and, he was having the exact same problem, and he was talking about it. He's like, you know, he'll be staring at, like, a doorway for 20 minutes, and then he's like, alright, nobody's coming, and then the second he turns around, somebody comes through that doorway and kills him. I have that problem all the time, guys. So as you see, 20 seconds left on the clock. I really want to get over 100 kills, but, so, you know, if I wasn't so defensive right here while my Blackbird was up, I could have gotten it, but, you know, I rush in too late, try and pick off the last few kills, get in there. I think I only got one more person. Yeah, that guy picks me up. And only get 93 kills. So 93-3. That ain't bad. That ain't half bad. I don't know what this voice is. That ain't a champion voice. I don't know what that is. But 93-3, that ain't bad. It's your boy P-Bat. Signing out. Hey, why don't you try some? Like this video. Just click the little thumbs up button. Let's see if we can get 1,000 likes. That'd be pretty boss. Peace out, guys.
Well done.